Hello everyone, today we are going to do this makeup look. As you can see, this is a full makeup look but in the rosy shade. If you want to see how I did it, continue watching. We are going to begin with the skin. I'm going to put on the Skin Foundation SPF 15 from Bobbi Brown. Don't forget to shake this product before using it. So I'm going to put one pump on my hand. Then I'm going to take my foundation brush. This is the Full Coverage Face brush from Bobbi Brown. And I'm going to apply the foundation where I need it the most, so in the center of my face. I quite like this foundation, this is quite natural. I think I need a little bit more, so I'm going to put half a pump on my hand, like this, and I'm going to apply a little bit more. I'm happy with the result. Now I'm going to put on my concealer. I'm using the Soft Matte Complete Concealer in Chantilly from NARS with my ring finger, and I'm going to apply some under my eyes. A little bit in the outer corner because I have some redness there. I'm looking at my skin, a little bit here on some pimple, a little bit on my blemish. Don't forget to blend around your pimple, maybe a little bit more on my chin, around my nose, just a little bit. I'm applying my eyeshadow base. This is the Pro Prime Smudge Proof Eyeshadow Base in Clear from NARS 2. And I'm going to apply some on my eyelid until my eyebrow. I think that sometimes this base is moving my under eye concealer if I go too far here or here. So if you can, put your base before your under eye concealer. That's just a tip. I'm going to take my hand and press the foundation on my skin just to make it look more natural, to blend everything with the warmth of my finger. Now I'm going to set my skin with the Tintest Un Powder from RMS Beauty, the tinted one in 01. I'm taking a small brush and I tap the excess in the cap, and then I'm tapping my brush where I need it. Under my eyes. I think it's better to set your face before doing your eye makeup, because if you have some fallout, you can just swipe them away. And with the rest, I just blend everything. I'm going to do a little bit of a contour, so I'm using the Filmstar Bronze and Glow in Fair Medium from Charlotte Tilbury, and I'm using the bronzer powder with kind of a thin brush, and I'm going to do a contour from the top of my ear towards my mouth, but I don't go very far. The concentration of the color must be near my hairline, under my chin, on my neck, a little bit on my temple. For my blush, I'm going to use the Rocator from Benefit, this one here. I have it in this palette, but you can have it separately. With the Sheer Powder brush from Bobbi Brown, I'm going to put it in the center of my cheek. A little bit above the apple of my cheek, you see, when I smile, the most up part is here. But I put my blush a little bit higher, just to have this lifting effect. And I blend it towards my temple. I will see later if I need more. For my eyes, I'm going to use the Burgundy Times 9 eyeshadow from MAC. So this is this one. I'm going to take the Luxe Crease from Zoeva 228. And I'm going to take Oaks, this one. This is like a mauvey pink. And I'm going to apply it on my crease, and I'm going to blend it on my eyelid. You can keep your eyes open during this step. This is maybe a little bit easier, and I'm extending the eyeshadow a little bit. I'm going to apply it also on my eyelid. The light is changing, I'm sorry. I'm doing this in front of a mirror, of a window, sorry. The sun is going and coming back. I'm really taking my time because I like to apply more to have more pigment. I'm taking a small pencil brush. This is the mini round Luxie 141. And I'm taking the same shadow oak and I'm applying it underneath. I'm really going until my inner corner and I extend it in my outer corner to bond the eyeshadow from my upper lid with my bottom line. I'm going to take a smaller brush. This is the Luxe Petite Crease 231 from Zoeva. And I'm going to use Quarry. This is a matte shadow, a little bit more gray. I'm going to apply it on the crease to deepen it. I go a little bit in my inner corner to define a little bit more my crease there. And I'm adding more shadow, blending to have the intensity that I desire. Then I'm putting the same shadow in the outer corner. And I'm doing my shape again, a little bit extended. I try to do the same shape in both eyes. Then I'm taking back my first brush and I'm blending a little bit of this gray shadow underneath at the outer corner. Now I want a little bit more pink, so I'm going to take Star Violet, this one. This is a really pink shadow with a little bit of glitter, not glitter, but it's a little bit shiny. And I'm going to apply this in the center of my eyelid. And with the same brush, I'm blending. I'm going back with my first brush, the big blending brush. And I'm blending everything. With the flat brush, this is the Luxe Smoky Shader 234 from Zoeva. I forgot to tell you. I'm going back with oaks. I'm going to take a little bit of oaks in my inner corner. In my outer corner. A little bit more underneath. I'm taking the same brush that I applied the shimmery shadow on. Like that I have also a little bit of pink underneath. Last step for my eyes, I'm going to take Sketch and Hashtag Noir. These two, I'm going to blend these two with a angled brush. This one. This is an old one from Coastal Scents. And I'm going to push the shadow between my lashes. I'm just pressing the brush at the root of my lashes. I'm pretty happy with the result. I'm going to do my eyebrow, so I'm putting the Glossier Boy Brow in blonde. In the wrong way, and then I put everything in place. I think I need a little bit more blush, but I think this one is not pink enough. So I'm going to take the Ervana from Benefit. This one, this is a lot more pink with the same brush I used earlier. And I'm going to apply more. I put a little bit too much, so I'm going to take my powder brush and I'm going to blend it. For my highlighter to finish my skin, I'm going to use the Living Luminizer from RMS on my cheek. On my nose, in my inner corner. Underneath my eyebrow. I'm going to finish my eyes with some mascara. I'm using the mascara from the brand Rouge. I'm going to put a lot of mascara. I'm going to let this coat dry and I'm going to apply another one a little bit later and do my under eyes lashes. During these times, I'm going to put on my lipstick. I think I'm going with Mer from MAC. This is a matte one, so don't forget to exfoliate your lips or at least put a good coat of lip balm on before. I'm going to correct with a clean finger. I'm going to take my finger and I'm going to do that to avoid some lipstick to go on my teeth. I'm taking a tissue and I'm going to put it on my lips to put away the excess. Then I go back with my mascara. Last step of the makeup, I promise. It's finishing my eyebrows, so I'm taking the Taupe Brow Powder Duo from Anastasia, the Browline 322 brush from Zoeva, and I'm taking the darker shade and I'm going to put it where I need it. I'm dipping my brush only once. The makeup is done, hope you enjoy. If you want to see more video, there is going to be some video here, here and so on. Don't forget to tell me in the comment section which color do you prefer to wear during fall. I really like burgundies, a little bit of orange on my makeup, not on my clothes. But anyway, I will see you next week. Thanks for watching.